Good morning. Welcome to the second sequence of the seventh series of the Pacific series. Let's go. We're going to start laying down on the mat in our regular Shavasana. So remember, the first thing we do, unless we come from another session, but if we are just starting here today, the first thing we do is bringing the senses inward, dropping down, within, going within, landing on the mat with the body, but also landing on the body with all the senses and the mind, and then connecting with the movement of the breath in the body, which actually keeps the mind present within. And that's the very first thing we do in every single session. Every time we start the practice, we do this, pratyahara, and connecting with the breath, mindful breath. Beautiful. Now, keep the focus, keep that atmosphere while bringing the knees to the chest, lengthening the lower back, and then the knees move away from each other, so you're opening the groins. And then what we want to do here is to draw a beautiful smile on the ground with the pelvis. So that's the movement of the pelvis. We are not working on the hip joints. We are not doing this. The hip joints stay without moving. There is no movement there. All the movement happens, the whole pelvis moving. So basically what happens is ribs on one side closing and then ribs on the other side closing. Beautiful smile. It's like an accordion. You open one side and the other side closes. And then the other way around. You are not moving your legs, you are just moving your pelvis in a beautiful smile shape. Stop the movement and then stretch your legs down, feet together, flex the feet, bring the arms up, palms facing each other. Now, stretch the right side as much as you can. So send the right heel down, send the right fingertips up, moving them away from each other. There's a lot of space on the right side, the whole leg. This is the muscles around the pelvis. Abdomen, rib cage on the right side, right armpit, right arm. Long, long, long line. Good, relax that effort and do the other side. So lengthen, stretch the left side, lengthen it as much as you can, the foot moving away from the hand. And then you feel the leg as long as you can, a lot of space in your pelvis, in your hip joint, around your iliac crest, and then the abdomen. Ribs, the arms. armpit, the arm, the fingers. Good, and then relax. Kick up your knees again, roll to the side and sit up. Beautiful. Cross the legs, and now let's do it. Let's change the crossing of the legs. Let's do the uncomfortable way, or not so comfortable. Roll the pelvis so the spine can lengthen. Relax the grip in your joints. Soft in your shoulders. Connect with the breath. Good. Plant the right hand level with the hip but far. Roll the shoulder, bend the elbow. Find a lot of space on the left side. A lot of space for the ribs, the armpit, the arm. And then move towards the left here. You're opening the left side. And while opening the left side, it feels like the right side is closing, yeah? We're gonna play today with the movements of expansion and compaction, which are actually the same thing. It's two sides of a coin, yeah? There is no, it doesn't exist one without the other. Good. Inhale up and change sides. So, lengthening, creating a lot of space here, and then moving towards the right here. You can put the focus, bring the focus to the expansion on the right side, or the focus to the compaction on the left side. When we are doing this, we have a tendency to observe more the expansion. But we could observe both. And then, how does the breath on the right line that has more space feel? But also, can I keep a nice breath on the left line that has less space? Good. Inhale up. And then interlace the fingers, turn the palms, keep a really, really long spine. And then the palms of the hands as high up as you can without arching the lower back. Creating a lot of space both in the front and at the back. So the moment I arch, there is more space at the front, less at the back, yeah? And then the breath. Good, bring the arms down. The left hand will grab the right wrist at the back and then fall forward. The movement is more towards the center now. We are working more on compaction than expansion. But understand that compaction requires a lot of space. If there is no space in my hips, there is no nice folding on the parts of the body, then I cannot compact. I will be here. There is no compaction. So in order for compaction to work, we need to have a lot of space so the parts of the body can fold nicely. So they need to be flexible enough so they can fold nicely. And flexibility is this ability to both. Okay, enough. Go to hands and knees, and then let's do our regular Marjoriasana. Find the perfect alignment, spread the knee, the fingers. Inhale, arch. And exhale, round, drop the head. Inhale, arch. And exhale, round, drop the head. Arching. And rounding. Here, you can observe that when you open the front side, the back side closes a little bit more, or the opposite, when you open the back side, the front side closes a little bit more. So those two movements are always happening together. Sometimes you will see we will kind of challenge this, but they are always there. And it's interesting to understand that compaction requires a lot of space as well. Good. Stop the movement. And then bring the right leg up, parallel to the ground. You don't want to bring it higher up, just parallel to the ground. And then left arm parallel to the ground. And now create space between the right foot and the left hand. As much space as you can. head. A lot of distance between the right foot and the left hand. Good. The head goes down, the knee goes down, and we do the other side. Left leg, right arm. And then a lot of space. Goes down, and then bring both hands a little bit farther. Tuck the toes in, bring the hips up, roll the shoulders down, out. Now we will all, each of us start bending the legs. It's a nice bend, it's not just a tiny bend. Bend the legs. Now push with the right hand on the ground and send the right hip away, lengthening, creating a lot of space on the ribs and the abdomen on the right side. So the right leg is already a little bit straighter than the left. Now let's do the same on the other side. Push with the left hand, send the left hip as far as you can, send it more, farther from the hand, creating more space on the ribs, more space on the abdomen. Wow, now there is so much space in your ribs, in your abdomen, but also in your armpits. Your arms are super long. And then keeping that space, keeping that length on both sides, see if you can stretch the legs a little bit more. But you don't want to lose not even a millimeter of that space, that length that you've gained. And then the heels to the ground, and the breath helping, that effort you're making to keep the space. And then softening in the effort so the energy can flow. Beautiful. Now inhale, right leg up. Bend the knee, open the hips. So the right side of the body opens, the right hip on top of the left hip. Stacking the hips. Good. And then the foot in between your hands. We will bring the back leg up, but drop the pelvis as much as you can without bending the back knee. We did this in the last sequence. And then inhale, arms up. Roll the pelvis, protecting the lower back. Let the pelvis be heavy. Open the arms, open the chest, feel the breath. Find this little expand, this nice expansion. And then arms down, front foot to the back. Push with your hands, lengthen the spine. All that space. And then left leg up. Bend the knee, open the hips, the left side opening. And now the foot in between your hands, the back leg straight, but the pelvis gets low. And now remember, you will have to turn the pelvis as you move up to protect the lower back. Open the arms, open the chest, open the chin, and then the breath, wide and deep. Beautiful. Now bring the hands down, and then back foot to the front and drop Uttanasana. Inhale, roll up. Tadasana, and stay. Beautiful. Open your eyes, spread the legs, outside of the feet parallel, please. A generous stance, Don't be here. A generous stance. Good. As always, roll the pelvis so the lower back is heavy. You are engaging the lower, the pelvic floor, Mula Bandha, engaging the lower abdomen. Beautiful. And then simply, we will slide the hands through the outside of the legs, going down. Keep the spine long, keep it long, 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 until you feel you need to round in order to keep on going down. Drop the head. Wherever you are, you're perfect. Wherever your hands are, those of you who have the hands already on the feet will do an extra movement, an extra action, which is bending the elbows towards the legs and pulling the body backwards. Okay, hands down to the ground, and now heels in, so the toes are opening outwards, and then bend the legs, position the pelvis and the shoulders right on top of your hips, feel that elasticity, yeah, this movement of and then arms, bend the elbows, do this mudra, jnana mudra with your hands, and keep on moving. I want you to feel this movement of expansion and compaction, which is the same movement of the heart, and it's the movement of the energy. Yeah? And it's what we call vitality. Good. Now stretch the legs. Feet parallel. Let's start here. Feet parallel. We're gonna work on Trikonasana. But we're going to do a dissection of the posture. Let's start by opening the right foot and then closing the toes of the back foot in a little bit, left foot in. We want to make sure that there is a straight line between the heel and the bridge of the back foot. It's a straight line that it's parallel. So my foot is not here or there, it's just there, so the bridge is in line with the heel. That's the perfect stance for Trikonasana. The pelvis is open. I'm not closing the pelvis. The pelvis is open. The first thing to do is to do the same with it on the ground at the beginning of the session. Draw a beautiful smile with the pelvis. So we will send the left hip up and the right hip in. Yeah, this movement. Tuck. As far as we can. Left hip up, right hip in. More, 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 more. Beautiful. Now, once I'm here, one of the things I can realize is that the ribs on the right side are open. Let's open them more. So bring the right arm next to the ear and lengthen, create even more space for the ribs and the armpit, and then go as far as you can with this right hand. Far, far, far. Go as far as you can. You're reaching out. Creating a lot of space for the ribs, the lower ribs, yeah? Now bring the hand down, without moving the ribs, just bring the hand down, keep the space on the ribs, and bring the left arm up. Usually, we want to go lower, but the moment we go lower, the spine does like this, it rounds. I'm closing the ribs on the right side, opening the ribs on the left, and the spine is more drawing an arch than a straight line. But what I want is to keep the space on the lower ribs, go as low as I can, but keeping the space on the lower ribs, which requires this movement, this smile of the pelvis. So here, what we're trying to do is, instead of doing the accordion, we're trying to keep both ribs open. So I'm doing the smile with my pelvis, but I'm trying to keep the ribs open on both sides. There you go.
Bend the front leg to move up. Feet parallel. Slide the hands down. Okay. Then, some of you will be bending the knees. Some of you will be with straight legs. Wherever you are, walk with your hands a little bit farther, but to the front. But then, grab the ground with your hands. Nice grip. And send the pelvis as far back as you can. Actually, you want the pelvis farther back than your heels. So what you do is you create a lot of space in your spine, in your ribs, in your armpits. It's almost the same back, the same line that we are drawing when we are doing Adho Mukha. It's almost the same. It should look the same. Then the breath. Where is the breath? And is the breath helping? The breath should be always helping. Beautiful. Hands go down, back, and then close the heels, bend the legs, go up. Arms up. Jnana Mudra. And find the movement. Beautiful. Stretch the legs, feet parallel. Let's go for Trikonasana on the other side. So open the left foot, close the toes of the right foot. Make sure that you have a straight line from the heel to the bridge of the back foot and keep the pelvis open. You don't want this, you want this, in this plane. Now from here, the smile of the pelvis, this time. The left pelvis goes up, and the right hip goes up, the left hip goes in. More, 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 as much as you can. Beautiful smile. There you go. Now you can already feel the ribs on the left side open. Let's go even more. So stretch the arm next to your ear. Send the arm up, up, up. And then go as far as you can. You're going to draw kind of an arch with your hand. Going as far as you can. Farther. 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 Keep the space. Bring the hip in. Farther. Farther. There you go. When you cannot go any farther, it's time to bring the hand down. Make sure that when you bring the hand down, you are not closing the ribs. You keep the ribs open, you're still reaching, simply bring the arm down, but you're still reaching out, yeah? Forward. Good. And then the arm up. Now it's when we, all of us, we have this tendency to want to go for the ground. So we want to get lower. It's okay. You can get lower as long as you keep the space on the ribs, lower ribs. So if getting lower means this, it's not really interesting, yeah? We're gonna keep the ribs on the left side open and also keep, obviously, the ribs on the right side open. So there is a constant movement of pelvis in, hip joint in, left hip joint in, and armpit moving away from the hip joint. That's the action here. And the smile in the pelvis. Inhale, and then exhale, feet parallel, slide your hands down, and go down again. Then, those of you who have the hands already on the feet, will grab the big toes, and then again, pulling the body towards the legs by sending the arms towards the legs.
there is a constant rotation of the pelvis, moving the sitting bones away from the heels to create even more space in the spine. Good, heels in, bend the legs all the way up.
Jnana mudra. Jnana is the knowledge,
yeah?
Is the mudra of the knowledge. Good. And then we're gonna go for our balancing posture. We want to keep that a lot of space on the ribs on both sides for this posture. So we're gonna use what we just did. To do a posture that can use all that space. Mm-hmm. So bring the arms up. Let's start with the right foot on the ground. So bring the arms up, lengthen as much as you can, and then bring the left foot back. It's a small step. And now feel the line that goes from the fingertips towards the left foot, yeah? You want to create a straight line, and then you start shifting the weight towards the right foot, and now, yeah, moving from the right hip, you will bring the rest of the body parallel to the ground. Good, let's go back, lengthen, and then bring the arms down, give yourself a little bit of time in Tadasana to feel. Yeah, and let's change legs. So, let's start by lengthening. Creating a lot of space, go with the fingertips high, up, and then the back, the right foot back. Feel the line from the right heel to the right fingertips, and then shift the weight towards the left leg, and start moving the whole body in a line, parallel to the ground, on top of the left leg. Good, let's undo, lengthen, and then Tadasana. And stay and feel. Inhale up. And then exhale, fall, Uttanasana. And then you're gonna sit, try to keep the heels on the ground. Keep the heels on the ground if possible. You might need to sit on the ground here or not, but I want you to make the ball of yourself compaction. Sit, stretch the legs. Some of you will need a little bit of bend on your knees in order to keep the spine long, otherwise you will feel like you're here, which is not good. So if you want to roll the pelvis, that requires for some of you bending the legs. Some of you are already flexible enough and you can do it with straight legs. Let's start by opening the heart towards the right, opening the right arm back, and then the left arm moves towards the finger, towards the toes, and as far to the front, yeah, you're reaching forward but not back, but forward with his left hand to create this nice spinal twist. Look back. Beautiful. Undo. Reposition. And let's do the opposite. So open the chest towards the left. The left arm moves back. And then the right hand reaching forward in direction to your toes. So you can spiral more in your spine. Look back. Beautiful, go back. There you go. Hands together under your butt, as close to your feet as possible. Shoulder blades kissing. And then elbows in, forearms down to the ground. Don't open your elbows, bring the elbows in. Now, push with the forearms against the ground, send the chest up, opening the sternum, opening the ribs on the front side, create more space, and then drop the head, unless your cervicals are hurting, but if it's just discomfort, drop the head. And then a wide, generous breath on your ribcage. Good, now bring the head up and round the spine down. Oops. Knees to the chest. Let's create this nice compaction, this movement towards the center, which is the other coin of the expansion. There is this constant beat of expansion, contraction or compaction and expansion. Yeah? And then compaction requires a lot of flexibility, so all the parts of the body can fold neatly, nicely. So if I'm not flexible, maybe I'm here. The knees cannot get closer. Compaction is not happening unless there is enough space so everything can fold nicely. So space is happening both with the extension and the compaction. It's just a different type of organization of the body. Good. And then bring the legs down, stretch the legs, arms up. Let's do the same at the beginning. Stretch the right side, foot moving away from the hand. Find a lot of space on the right side. Ah, almost you feel like yawning here when you do this. Ah, and then the left side. Good. And then you relax in your Ramar Shavasana. And today, feeling this movement of compaction and expansion, which are two coins of the same movement, which is the beating of your heart, the pumping of your blood, the beating of your of the universe. And this is what we call vitality. Feel your energy moving like this towards the center and then expanding.
You will stay here for as long as you want, contemplating the movements of expansion and compaction, the beating of the heart, the beating of the universe, of the cosmos in your body, or you will move to the next sequence. It's up to you. Namaste, thanks for being here and doing this exploration.